Hi there. I want to talk to you today about robbing behavior. It's July 15th. We're out putting bee escapes on colonies this year, and we're starting to see a little bit of robbing behavior, so I thought this was a good time to film this video. Robbing behavior, bees will go from their hive to anything around them that's sweet and try to steal that. So that could be honey that's exposed, not inside a hive, or it could be going into a hive and getting after the honey that's stored in a hive. When bees learn where there's food, they go back and they do a dance inside the hive. We all know that they can indicate where to go to find flowers at some distance. But when the resource is quite close by, like in the apiary where the hive is located, they do a round dance. So that's just a little round dance, and all it tells the other bees is get out and get lucky. So then you'll start seeing bees checking out cracks. Anywhere they can smell any bit of honey, they'll look for an entrance into the colony. So they're very good at communicating that, and robbing can turn on very quickly. So what we try to do is prevent robbing, not being able to eliminate. We really are just trying to minimize the damage that could occur. Robbing can spread diseases from one colony, so that's a prime reason why honeybees get American foul brood from other sick hives. Bees from hives that are healthy get out and steal honey from the diseased hive and bring it home. So many different scenarios you end up in where you get some kind of bee robbing. Harvesting honey is one. So what we do is we keep the honey covered as we're harvesting it, so not a lot of scent is coming off to attract the bees, and it eliminates their access to the honey. So as you take a super off, keep it covered up until you get it inside your honey house. So when we put bee escapes on, we have to be especially careful that there is no holes. There's a bee escape on here. We have to make sure there's no holes above that bee escape. Once these bees clear down through the bee escape, come down through these openings here, there's no bees up here to protect the honey, and if there happened to be a hole, robber bees will get in there and steal that honey. And then there's a lot of fighting. The dead bees from the fighting get clog up the bee escape, and it's just a bad situation. If there is anywhere where bees can get in through a little crack, we tape that up with painter's tape, push it down really well and seal it up. And it only needs to be on there for three nights. We leave the bee escapes on for three nights, and then we can take that tape off at that point. So good solid equipment is the best defense there, but if you have older equipment with some cracks, you can just tape them up. So another situation where robbing can be a problem, if you harvest honey and you put it in your garage or somewhere like that, and then bees can get into that, or heaven forbid you leave a door open a crack, you'll get a lot of bees inside there, and they're really a nuisance when you have large numbers of bees inside a building. So you need to keep facilities bee tight so that you don't have bees getting in there. We occasionally have problems with we have so many bees in this area when we're harvesting our honey right here, that can be a problem, so we have to be really vigilant. But what some beekeepers choose to do is not have any bees on the property where they extract their honey, because that helps prevent robbing behavior inside the facilities. Sometimes robbing behavior gets so bad that some individual colonies get kind of picked on, and you'll see huge amounts of activity near the entrance, a lot of fighting bees at the entrance. And if we have a wide open entrance, it's very difficult for the guard bees to protect their hive. So what we can do in that case is reduce the entrance, and that'll help stop the swarming from happening. An upper entrance like this is fine. It's nice and small, easy to defend. But this big wide entrance at the bottom is less easy to defend. And so we can just tuck an entrance reducer in there, and that'll make it much easier for the bees to defend their entrance. In the spring of the year, when we first check on our colonies, sometimes we think we have a live hive, when actually what we have is a dead hive that's being robbed. So lots of bees going in and out of the entrance. If that happens for any length of time, you'll see this sticky residue near the entrance. As the bees come out, they wipe their feet off before they fly home, and so they leave this residue at the front of the hive. So that's a telltale sign. When we come back from the bee yard, when we're harvesting honey, we unload as quickly as possible before bees smell what's going on, and we're able to get it into the building before there's too much robbing starting. But we do have to move quickly. Anytime we have loads sitting around, if the load shifts at all and there's any openings, bees will be finding that honey inside there. So we really want to protect all this honey from robber bees. So we tape it up there whenever they're above the bee escape, because we could come back in 2 or 3 days and have our honey totally gone, robbed out by other bees. Very disappointing. So we do a number of different measures to suppress robbing behavior. We can't totally eliminate it, but we can keep it down and to help prevent disease transmission in our colonies. This robbing behavior happens when there are nectar flows aren't on. So in the spring of the year, in the fall of the year after the flowers finish blooming, but even through the summer, the flow will start and stop within a day. And so this behavior can pick up pretty rapidly. Thanks for watching. See you another time.